Hi, my name is Deb Enright, and this is Money Matters. Thank you for joining us. And as always, thank you to Daryl Thompson of Raymond James for his generous sponsorship of our Money Matters program. Today, we let you in on one of the best kept secrets of Williamson County Schools. We plan to showcase the incredible strength within our schools that ignites the imagination of our students, brings smiles to our parents, and stretches our faculty to provide new and unique opportunities for all of our students from kindergarten through the senior year of their high school experience. The showcase happens the last week of this month, March 28th through 29th. We launch at the Franklin Theater and take over the factory through that Saturday. Anyone within the sound of my voice can join us as Williamson County Schools, for the very first time, celebrates the fine arts through a festival that shows off all the things our students create in the art studio on stage and for the concert hall. We are joined today on Money Matters by the visionary of this wonderful opportunity, our fine arts curriculum specialist, Melissa Dufrechou. Melissa will give shape to the design for the festival, and then we will meet one of the community players helping us with this event, as well as one of the student participants and a faculty member, making sure that her students' work is showcased for the community to enjoy. Honestly, you'll be wowed with the organizations involved with celebrating the fine arts in our Williamson County schools. We have a lot of ground to cover on the program, so stick with me through this break and prepare to get excited about the first ever Williamson County Schools Fine Arts Festival coming to you March 28 and 29 as Melissa Dufrechou joins me to set the stage for the festival. We'll be right back with more Money Matters.
When sharing the road, reaction time is important. Motorists should reduce their speed and avoid tailgating, especially in bad weather. Cyclists have the same rights and responsibilities as motorists. They should travel in the same direction on the right hand of the road and obey all traffic signals. Observing these rules provides predictability for both motorists and cyclists. Remember, same roads, same rules, same rights.
Welcome back to Money Matters. Melissa Dufrechou is the WCS Fine Arts Curriculum Specialist and the driving force behind the Fine Arts Festival. In her second year here at the schools, Melissa's energy and focus continue to strengthen the fine art offerings and opportunities for our students. Melissa, it's great to have you back here on Money Matters.
Thank you so much for having me on your show.
Well, it's a delight, and I'm very excited about this festival. But here's my first question for you. How is a fine arts curriculum specialist who's all filled with scope and sequence, how is it that you're putting together this entire community event that lasts over 2 days and celebrates thousands of kids during that time?
Well, yes, my job is about curriculum, but it's really more than that. My focus is to help promote and advocate for our fine arts students and our teachers to help grow what we do in the programs here.
So the festival is a way to, on a very large scale, do that. Talk to me about what you envision and what it's going to look like.
Well, the Williamson County Schools Fine Arts Festival is a, like you said, a two-day event, and it starts with a kickoff concert with a local group performing at the Franklin Theater, and then Saturday at the factory in downtown Franklin is a full day of kindergarten through 12th grade performances. We have band students, we have choral programs, we have theater performers, we have string ensembles, we've got ORF groups, we have just a little bit of everything, and we will also have an art display up, which will actually stay up for a whole week.
Oh, that's wonderful. Okay, so I know the when is at the end of March, so in a couple weeks, and I know the what, right? It's all the kids, but how did this come about? I mean, when you were getting all the professional development stuff together, when you were talking with your faculty, when you were getting them all excited about all the kids coming into their classrooms, What caused you to say, we have to do this?
Well, you know, Williamson County is a district that wants to be nationally recognized in the academics and arts and athletics. And so what better way to celebrate with our community what we're doing and what more we want to do and what more we can do for our students? And this is a great opportunity for us to really showcase all of our students at once to the entire community and not just one school at a time here and there. And so we're really excited to be able to bring this together.
So tell me the response from the schools and the teachers. I mean, did you say, all right, we've got this space and this opportunity, who wants to play? I mean, how did that go?
Well, I have actually had to stop accepting performers.
I love that.
We have a very full docket. We will be in two different rooms at the factory. We'll be in Liberty Hall and the Commons area.
Wow.
So there will not be a minute of silence during the day.
Good.
With performers all day. And people have just jumped on board to participate in this event.
Well, how fun to have kindergartners all the way up to kids who are just getting ready to graduate and perhaps pursue some kind of artistic field in terms of their post-secondary kind of work, to have a chance to say to the community, here we are, here's what we're doing in our classrooms. That's got to be so exciting. So on Friday, we get to kick off with a very special venue. The Fine Arts Festival's success depends on the support we receive from our community. As usual, one key player in the community has stepped forward to offer a partnership with Williamson County Schools that starts our festival off with a bang. The Franklin Theater, of course, will host our opening night celebration concert on Friday, March 28th. Tickets are available on the Franklin Theater site. So, Melissa, will you stay with me? We talked with Dolly Chandler, who's the program director at the theater, about this exciting partnership. We'll be back in a minute. So we're joined today on Money Matters by Dolly Chandler, who's the program director at the Franklin Theater here in downtown Franklin. She's been kind enough to invite us into the theater to ask a couple questions about partnership with the district, and specifically this very exciting thing that happens at the end of March that we're talking about on the show, the Fine Arts Festival, the first Williamson County Fine Arts Festival. So, Dolly, thank you for joining us today.
My pleasure.
Okay, let's get right down to it. I want to know what excites you, or what is exciting about bringing the district together with the efforts of the Franklin Theater.
Oh, well, we see it as just the opportunities being endless. Part of our mission in being a community theater is to give back to our community, especially through education, both adult and, you know, with students. So needless to say, you know, we've got the Williamson County School District is so wonderful at what they do and affects so many people in our community and beyond. That we really have been working really hard, actually, to develop a partnership, not just, you know, provide space for you all, but to actually, you know, to do things with you and to support you all, whether it is using our facility or it's providing opportunities for your students and your teachers to come in and learn a little bit about what we do from an arts perspective, you know, how we put things on stage, what it takes to make things sound good, to make things look good, the business side of it all. So we're excited to do those kind of things, to provide our space for meetings, for some of the administrators, and then also to do things like the Fine Arts Festival kickoff concert, which we're excited about. So it's not just a one-time thing as far as the theater's concerned. It's developing that partnership and watching it grow and watching the children get excited about arts in our community, and even, like I said, maybe the business side of things. You never know what somebody's gonna fall into. So we're happy to be able to provide that for the community. So.
That's wonderful. Let's talk about the Fine Arts Festival, because it is really exciting. First ever in the district that at least that I understand. Mm-hmm. And so Friday night, this gorgeous space will launch or
start or whatever. The event itself. Thank you. The event itself, and we have a wonderful group called Bailey and the Boys,
yes.
And
who are local. They all live in Williamson County, so they're definitely excited to be a part of supporting the fine arts programs in the schools. So.
Yeah, it's really fun to find. I mean, obviously, when you live in Music City and its outskirts, there's a great group of talent. And it's really been everywhere. And it's really nice that these folks also want to engage in what we're doing, mm-hmm. which is terrific. Because it's really great for kids to see that you guys care about them and that there are artists who tour the world who also care. Mm-hmm. So we're excited about that. Mm-hmm. Let's talk a little bit about describe now. Okay, so you're partnering with us for the Fine Arts Festival kickoff event. It's going to be the Friday night, the 28th of March. Mm-hmm. What does it mean to partner for this particular thing that you're doing?
Well, I think, you know, it's basically the beginning of what we hope to be, again, I hate to keep using the word partnership, but for the schools, what we hope to be a long-term benefit to the fine arts programs, because I know I grew up in Williamson County Schools. Yay, go Fairview. And I was a member of the band there, and I was a member of the chorus. But, you know, unfortunately, sometimes those programs don't get as much attention or support from a financial standpoint as I'm sure that the administrators would like to be able to kind of do more with the programs and get more kids involved. So I'm excited about it personally because I think that that's a need that needs to be filled. And this particular event is specifically for the fine arts programs in Williamson County Schools, nothing else. So it's focusing on the creative arts, the talent and the, not necessarily even those who don't have the talent now, but the developing talent for, you know, the students in the fine arts program, the creative arts and the fine arts music and everything. And they're just covering it all, too, which I love. So the event here is going to be kind of a part of the fundraising effort, but mainly it's the first one to just raise awareness and say, hey, this is what we're doing. You know, we're really making a commitment to the fine arts programs in our schools, and this is how we're going to do it. And we're going to display our talent, and we're going to, you know, hopefully get more people involved in supporting the programs in the schools. So.
Okay, so we've talked to me now about, I want folks to understand how much time you folks give to something like this and what it means to bring people in. So, the band will start to load in at what time?
Oh, we're going to go. You want specifics.
I want logistics so that they really see what this commitment means.
Yeah, well, it is a big commitment from the time. I mean, I know you and I have been talking about and planning this, you know, the specifics of the event for, what, I'd say a couple of months now. So it is a big time commitment, but from that perspective, and then you guys are working on your end to, you know, get people involved and to sell the tickets and to promote. We're doing the same thing. You know, we've got a marketing department, and we are committing to helping you guys promote the event through some of our channels. We've got, of course, a technical staff that is handling all the production aspects, communicating directly with the band on their needs and, you know, what kind of things that they need to make the show a success from a sound standpoint. But they'll probably get in, again, so this is all like the build-up. This is all going on now even before the event. The day that of the event, they'll probably start loading in about anywhere between noon and 2. And we'll have movies that morning, so we'll have to get everybody out and then have our staff come in and help them set up, which, you know, could take three or 4 hours, depending on the complication, you know, level of their show. So then they'll do a sound check probably about 4 o'clock to make sure everything sounds good. And I know that there might be some students participating in the event as well, so we'll have to get them in and get them set up, make sure that they're comfortable and that they sound good on the stage. Of course, there's a green room area upstairs which will need to be, I guess, you know, packed with things for the band, and we'll help with that. But then after that, you know, the band's going to take some time to themselves and get ready for the show. And then after that, you know, we're opening the doors and it's game time. So, you know, hopefully we'll have a house full of people for the show. And then we'll have our front of house staff will come in and they'll start getting everything ready from the ticketing standpoint, getting the box office ready, the concessions area ready. And so,
yeah, it's a big deal. Yeah, it's not just opening the doors. I mean, yeah. it's a full day. And then there'll be the takedown as well.
And then after the show's over, it usually doesn't take as long to take down as it does to set up. But it's another couple of hours that we'll have our staff in here for, you know, tearing down the stage and then also cleaning up and everything, the front of the house, the concessions and getting all that stuff ready for the night. So
that's fabulous. Well, we really appreciate that. And can they get?
That's what we do.
I know, and you do it really well. And for so many nonprofits and other organizations, which I think is great about the Franklin Theater. It truly is community based.
Well, you know, something that we, on that note, that we always have to remind ourselves is that someone like you coming in and want to rent the venue or use the venue, especially from a fundraising aspect, you're thinking about this one event probably for a year or more. You know, it's the one event you're focusing on. It's the one big fundraiser or awareness campaign that you have, and you're putting everything in this event. And, you know, and we partner with you and we help you and, you know, and we help you coordinate things and we make it run smoothly, but we do it every day. So sometimes we forget that, you know, to you, it's a one-time thing and you're nervous and you've got so much anxiety or, you know, I mean, just in general, some people who come in and rent the venue. But if hoping that this, I'm saying this so that it may calm some people's nerves, but we do this every day. I mean, you know, this is something that we know like the back of our hand, and we have everybody's best interest in mind. You know, we want you to sound good, we want you to look good, and we want you to raise awareness and make the money that you're trying to make. So, but it's our business. So we hope that whenever we have these people coming in to use our venue, that, you know, we can provide a little bit of calmness and assurance that, you know, we know from our end we've got everything taken care of. So,
well, it's a great service because it's more about the seats and the roof and the sound system.
Yeah.
I mean, it really is this full support, and we certainly appreciate it because, just as you said, it's kind of a learn by doing for us.
Yeah.
And so to have experts walk with us, it's really great. Well, as we wrap, and folks are interested in tickets to this marvelous event, can we get them through you?
Absolutely. The tickets are already on sale on our website, so you can go to www.franklintheater.com. And of course, theater is spelled the old-fashioned way, so it's theatre.com, franklintheater.com. And you can scroll down all of our events and you can find the ticketing there and you can purchase your tickets there. Or you can call the box office, which I don't have the number off the top of my head. But anyway, call our box office or even come down to the theater and just get your tickets at the window. So there's those three ways that you can get them. And then I'm assuming that the school has got something on their website, you know, where you can link to back to the theater as well. So
yeah, I think we're going to have kind of a, you know,
all points
bulletin out to get as many, because
right.
It would be really wonderful to have a full house just to say, welcome everyone.
Absolutely.
Here we go. Let's celebrate the arts in Williamson County Schools.
And like we said, hopefully this is a building campaign and that, you know, we can do this again next year and the year after, and it will just continue to grow. So let's have a good start.
That's great. Hey, Dolly, thank you so much
thank
for giving
you.
Us some of your time here on Money Matters.
We appreciate it so much.
We
love the school, so we're happy to help you out in any way.
So. Thanks so much.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Dolly. What a fantastic way to kick off the festival. March 28th at the Franklin Theater, Williamson County Schools presents an event showcasing local music industry talent and our own students in the premier music venue in Williamson County. It's exciting.
It is very exciting.
So after Friday, people can go and collect at the factory. Tell me what that day is going to look like for people.
Well, Friday, take your pick of what you enjoy. Starting at 9:30 in the morning, we have students just beginning on their string instruments, coming in to play and perform. We have choral groups who come in. We have elementary choral groups, as many as 150 kids on stage.
Oh my goodness.
And we have small chamber ensembles. We have woodwind ensembles and brass ensembles. We have several of our brand new string programs that will be performing. We have one group that will be doing selections from their musical this spring, Oklahoma.
Oh, how exciting!
We have another theater group that has written their own one-act play for this day.
Oh my goodness, I love this.
So we have so many things going on. You can walk down to Liberty Hall and there'll be two stages down there with performers, and then walk past all of the artwork that students will have displayed, and you can go see even more performances in the open commons area.
Now tell me, that there is a celebrity group I think you've mentioned in some of our meetings. Would you let me know who that might be?
At the end of the evening at 4:15, the Nashville Symphony Chamber Ensemble will be topping off our program with a free concert.
Oh my goodness. 4:15 on the Saturday. Okay.
4:15 on Saturday. The Independence High School Trium Organization, which is their Music Honor Society, is sponsoring a donation drive to give back to the symphony for all of the outreach that they have provided to our county schools.
How wonderful. How neat to think about the schools, because I think everyone associates, you know, there are resources that we could certainly use to beef up some of our music programs, but you folks are taking the time, and the school system as a collective is taking time to thank the symphony by raising some money for them. I love that, Melissa. That's great. I love that. But as we know, the fine arts also means studio art. I had the chance to speak with Brentwood High School art teacher Heather McHugh and one of her very talented students, whose work will be on display at the factory on the Saturday portion of our festival. Let me share that conversation with you now, and after, we will wrap up with Melissa for details on how you can celebrate the fine arts in Williamson County Schools with us. Stay with us.
So we're here at Brentwood High School. We are joined by Sylvia Schlunk, who's a senior, and by Heather McHugh, who is a visual arts and AP art history teacher. We're so glad you guys have joined us for Money Matters. There is this very special sculpture that I am in love with that's going to be on display at the festival. So Sylvia, to you, first question, how does art sit in relation to all your other academic work?
To be perfectly honest, kind of slightly above. I love art. I mean, academics are important too. I do actually get my other homework done, but I spend a lot of time outside of school working on art, and it dominates my time.
Now, is this the thing you're going to study after you graduate?
I'm going to study it. I'm not solely going to study it, though. I'm also going, I think, writing probably. But
so that's me too.
It's not ending here.
All the creative stuff. All right, so Heather, tell us about this piece and why this piece struck you as something that should be in the festival.
Well, the assignment was to do an assemblage, which is creating a sculpture out of found objects, and Sylvia's attention to detail and her use of materials is so incredibly profound. And her craftsmanship is monumental, and this piece is really quite advanced for somebody that I would expect to see in high school.
Great, and we're gonna show a bit of that. So tell me really quickly, maybe even in a word, what does it mean to have this piece on display with thousands of people looking at it during the Fine Arts Festival?
Intense.
I love that, intense. Sylvia and Heather, thank you so much for this time together. We are so excited that this and other pieces from around the district will be on display. Thanks for sharing your time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Too many of Tennessee's students drop out of high school. If you ask them why, you'll probably hear they just can't keep up because they don't have the reading skills. Success in school is based on success in reading, and learning to read starts with hearing words. With young children, storybook reading plays a special and important role.
Great. What's the last word?
Mom.
Good.
Have fun with reading. Read the directions on the box and bake a cake together. Work with your child to cut coupons and make a grocery list. Read a book about different occupations, then ask your child what they would like to be when they grow up.
What about an eye doctor, just like your granddaddy?
an eye doctor is much more. He works with some glasses.
He does.
Don't underestimate the impact that reading can have on your child's future. Choose success. Choose reading. This Choose Success moment has been brought to you by the Middle Tennessee P16 Council.
And welcome back to Money Matters. Melissa, as we wrap up the show, what do you want the community to know about getting involved with the Fine Arts Festival?
Well, there are three ways that the community can be involved.
Okay.
The first way is to become a sponsor and to purchase a sponsor table for the benefit concert on Friday night. And if anybody's interested in sponsoring, they can call me or they can send me an email and I can get them in touch with that.
Terrific.
The other way is to bring a new or gently used instrument on Saturday to the factory for one of our students to be able to use at school. And then, of course, the most important way to be involved is to come and to show up and to support the wonderful things that our students are doing here.
I am so excited about this. I can't believe it. It's only a couple weeks away. I'm so proud of the work that you're doing. This is a tremendous way to have the community become involved. So you can help support with the sponsoring of a table at the Franklin Theater. You can bring a tuba. I'm trying to make alliterations, but I can't do the next one. So you can bring either a gently used or new instrument for kids who are learning to get even better. And of course, please come. Please join us for what promises to be an absolutely fun weekend celebrating the fine arts in Williamson County Schools. Melissa, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
I am so excited about this event that we're going to have, and you'll have to come back and tell us how it went.
Absolutely. Look forward to it.
Great. Thank you so much. And we'll be back with a wrap-up of the show in just a moment. Stay with us.
WAKM AM 950, Williamson County's hometown radio, and WCTV, the education and government cable channel for Williamson County. Together, serving the fastest growing county in the great state of Tennessee.
Our job in our schools is to bring opportunities that create well-rounded students. The commitment to infusing the fine arts into our schools from kindergarten through high school is palpable. And we want you to know about it. We want you to see it and hear it. We want you to help us celebrate with our families as the Nashville Symphony Chamber Ensemble joins us through performance at the factory. We want you to support our efforts by buying tickets for the Friday night kickoff concert at the Franklin Theater with Bailey and the Boys. There are many ways to support this first ever Williamson County Schools Fine Arts Festival in March. Become an audience member at one of the dozens of concerts showcasing our students. Meander through the factory to gaze on the creative expressions of our artists. Or join the community sponsors and reserve a table for your friends and colleagues at the Friday night kickoff concert. Please mark your calendar, spread the word, bring your friends, and help us celebrate the wonder of our students' creativity. Because your support, your participation, your energy for an event like this proves how vital it is that our students stretch their creative muscles and build their imaginations to understand the power of self-expression. Our community will drive the success of this event, and that is why money matters. That is our show for today. Thank you for joining us. Thank you to Daryl Thompson and Raymond James for his continued support of our work here. My name is Deb Enright, and this is Money Matters.